There's a lot of simulator style games out there, and the newest one on PS4 is Hunting Simulator. But is this game the big game hunting experience that you want, or is it worse than taking an accidental gunshot? Hunting Simulator is a hunting simulator. It tries its best to be a realistic one, though it can be a little bit difficult to do that in a video game form, though it's more realistic than some of the other hunting-related style games available on the platform. The game has a multitude of different locations with a handful of missions on each of them for you to complete. Everything is basically locked from the beginning of the game though, so you have to slowly unlock the different locations by completing missions, and the same goes for unlocking the various accessories, items, and weaponry that you'll be able to use on these hunts. And while you do have the multiple locations, they all have basic themes like forest, desert, and a snowy area. They switch up between them, so it doesn't get quite boring as you're going through the main campaign mode, and the game breaks it up every so often with locations that are specific for duck hunting. When you're in campaign, you select which location you want to go to and then select which mission. The missions in the game pretty much involve killing one or more of a certain type of animal during the course of that particular hunt. You then get to set up your loadout. You can take two firearms, a handful of different items such as wind spray and a few other things like that, as well as a sight like binoculars, night vision goggles, or even a flashlight. Then when you jump into the hunt, it's up to you to track the animals, locate them, and eventually take them down for your trophies. The game features three different difficulties for the hunt, so if you want a more realistic style of hunting experience, you'll want to turn that difficulty up. Once the hunt begins, though, you'll be using your tracking skills in order to locate the animals. Basically, you'll walk around and it'll give you a notification of where a track is, go up to it, and it'll tell you coyotes heading northwest 3 hours ago. So heading that direction, you'll find more tracks eventually, hopefully leading to wherever the animals are currently at. You also have to take into account the caliber of your weapon, whether it's good for small, medium, or large animals. Taking out a small animal with a gun set for a larger animal will end up ruining it, and you won't be able to collect it for a trophy and thus complete the mission. Though, honestly, there's no visual difference when you shoot a smaller animal with a larger caliber. It looks exactly the same, just with a small bullet hole in it, which was a bit disappointing, which is something that came to be the case with a lot of the graphics in the game. It can be a little bit difficult at first to get your bearings and locate each of the animals that you're looking for. The game throws plenty of animals that you're not hunting for on that particular mission at you, but very few of the ones you actually meet, which gets a bit frustrating. There's also a stamina meter for running in the game to try to get to these locations, and covering long distances can also be troublesome. The game tries for that realistic approach, but with other elements of the game not being as realistic, this just ends up becoming a nuisance instead of a quality gameplay feature. Firing your weapon at the animals is an interesting one. It takes into account, of course, the shakiness of your arm, that you can hold your breath to get a better aim of your shot, as well as, of course, the wind that's going on and the type of weapon you're using can be affected by your shot. So if you fire at certain distances and there's wind involved, it may send your bullet off a little bit, though it still seemed like hit detection was a little bit all over the place during the course of me playing. And while the general progression of the missions is okay, thankfully the game does break things up with the duck hunting styles of levels. Here you're hunting four ducks in a small location instead of traveling around the map, and the ducks just keep coming at you one after another for you to take them down and collect as many as you need to for whatever mission you're on. The game does also feature a free hunt mode where you can go into any of the maps that you've unlocked and try to hunt certain animals, as well as there's also online play that you and some friends can get together and hunt down certain amounts of animals on the various maps as well. From the technical side of things, while the game didn't crash on me, there was some noticeable slowdown from time to time, especially going in and out of the scope at a couple of times, as well as with certain animals on screen. Speaking of the animals, the AI in them is a bit off. In fact, a giant bear I was able to kind of just run up to and stand in front of him. The bear just kind of pushed me around, and I was able to actually get inside the bear at one point, which was a little bit weird. I also had animals getting stuck on the various terrain, like inside of trees and rocks, and there's a lot of invisible walls when it comes to this. The game also has plenty of little cliffs and the like for you to climb up, some of which you can, some that you can't, and if you fall off a higher distance, instead of getting hurt or damaged, you just instantly respawn at the beginning of the map of whichever one you're currently on, which at one time I actually shot an animal but fell off too high of a little cliff and ended up losing the trophy that I had just shot because of this. The game also features a ton of texture popping. Just walking around, things like flowers and patches of grass and other stuff would just pop into place when you're walking around, which was off-putting and something that just bothers me in this day and age. Hunting Simulator is available now on Xbox One, PS4, and PC for $39.99. It does have a full trophy list and platinum on the PlayStation 4. Overall, Hunting Simulator is an okay hunting game. If you're desperate for a game like this on the system, you may want to check it out, but it is a little bit overpriced, and it's not an arcadey hunting game, so keep that in mind for those who enjoy that style. It tries to be more realistic, but even then, it's just okay in that department. With everything said, I'm going to be giving Hunting Simulator a just below average 4 out of 10. But anyway, guys, it's going to wrap up this review. I'd like to thank you for watching, and of course, I hope you enjoyed.